because of that. And my whole life is filled. Imagine your whole life filled with God's glory. And God's glory would mean that every area of your life would have healing in it. So maybe we're going to sing this, but like, why don't you just picture what that is? Maybe your marriage. My marriage has God's glory in it. My parenting, my children, my job. And maybe there's some, oops, my job. No, yeah, God's glory. Imagine God's glory. Because singing the whole earth is great, but it's so big. But if the streets of Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, you know what I mean? Imagine if this city had God's glory. And what I sense in my life when I go out and sing these songs, they're not just songs, they're not just going up, they're going out and around. And we're prophesying over this area. And I really love that I'm in Philadelphia today, tonight. I love that I'm singing these songs and we're going to have fun and we're going to speak and sing about God's glory coming in here, because that's really God's aim. And he's looking for his children to pull it down. Okay, God, can you pour your glory down over the open circle, over the streets, over this neighborhood, over the taco place around the corner, you know, over the Eagles Stadium and the Dolphins Stadium too. I don't want to, you know, you don't want to miss out on anything, you know. And the Dodgers, for goodness sake, they need God's glory. But that's what I sense. It's not just this scriptural nicety. It's like, no, it's true. I want to see God's glory like water in this building, in this room. So when people come up the stairs, and then people from your neighborhood, they want to come. I don't know why. I don't know why I want to go there, but I want to go because, I don't know, I feel good when I go there. That's to me what God's glory is. It's not just some spooky Christian thing. It's this changing my life thing. God's glory. We're just gonna play this, but in a minute we're gonna sing it. But just start thinking of your life. Where's the glory gonna go? Where's the glory gonna fall? Where do you need it most? Where does God's glory? I need it in my home life for my boys. I need God's glory to fall on them, so they can get to know him like I've enjoyed. That's what I want God's glory. I live and work in Hollywood. I want God's glory to come down with this. All the homeless people live around my neighborhood. That's where I want God's glory to come. Yeah. God's providence, let's think of that. God's providence is luxurious nature to come into our neighborhood. That's why the angels sing holy, 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 because they know what kind of guy he is. This guy comes through. You can't stop this guy when he wants to do something. You ask God to say, oh God, will you move on my life? And he will. It's a dangerous prayer to make. We've all done it, like, break me, make me, you know, oops. I knew I shouldn't have prayed that prayer. But I want to see God's glory in your life. I want to see God's glory in your songwriting. And you're not thinking about what's right or wrong. You're just writing because it's coming out of you. And you're singing and prophesying over your churches that you're in. You just can't help it. You start writing songs because your church needs this song now. It's a message that God's doing. That's God's glory coming. The whole earth is filled, but your whole life is filled.